So I just put the first coat, the white one, and it came up really good. So we're gonna wait for it to dry, and we're gonna put the second coat, okay?
Hi guys, so yeah, so in this video, we're gonna be replacing this Chevy Silverado door hinge, which is this one, already painted. So what we have here, we have three holes here, and each of them has is gonna have a screw here, and also there's one here on the on this hole in the front, which are these ones. So those ones are gonna be half inch, or you can also remove them with a 13 millimeter socket. And these ones on this side, they're gonna be 10 millimeter. So for this one on the this one is okay, but this one over here, the ones that are more inside, we're gonna be using this ratchet, which is a half inch on this side, and so it will give us more more space to work. Otherwise it's gonna get tough to get in. These ones over here, yeah, they're easy. And yeah, so I decided to replace the whole hinge because I bought this roller like, 2 months ago, and see what it happened. It didn't last. This little thing is by itself is like $32 on Amazon. So the hinge is like $24. So let's try this one instead of just replacing that one. And the thing is that this one also is, as you see over here, it's a little lower. So that's why we're gonna see with this new hinge that's will solve the problem. So these two screws over here, yeah, they're really hard to take them. So you're gonna need some extra time to take them out, okay? So just be patient. So this is the last one. So I'm using right here my leg as to lift the door, yes, if I need to. So this is the last screw. So now we have it out. We're gonna start putting the new one in, and we're gonna start with the long screws on the body. So that's gonna be the first one. Yeah, so here's how it look installed already. So one thing that I should tell you is to move this one all the way to this side, to the to your front when you're doing it. What I did is I left it like on the middle, so there was so the door was not closing properly, so I had to move this one all the way to the back, and then I was just so in order to adjust it, so I lose this screws a little bit, and then I just tightened the one on the front, and that's like a tip to, if you're doing it. So the last thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna put the spring on the hinge. So we're gonna use like this spring remover, and we're using a 13 millimeter socket to compress it, and then we'll just put it inside. So now it's installed, so it looks like it's working pretty good. I'm just gonna put a little bit of grease and that'll be all, okay? Thank you guys for watching. Yeah, please like, please subscribe, and I'll be uploading some more videos, okay? Thank you very much for watching. See you.